The following is a presentation of HEW Entertainment on their official website and a broadcast on social media. Listener's discretion is advised.
It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beat! The Man!
You gotta beat the man! Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada, have a like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the world heavyweight champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god. J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us. So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Don't miss out on any of the action. Download our app on the App Store, Google Play, and the official website of HEW Entertainment. Once you've downloaded and installed it, you'll get caught up on news, YouTube videos, and more. Download it now.
I've been stranded on a lonely street. Got lost in the shadows, fell hard in the battle, heard cries in the suffering. Walked through the darkness, left broken and heartless. I'm calling out.
My heart beats for love, it's the sound that
That is My Heart Beats for Love off the album I Can't Be Tamed from Miley Cyrus, which dropped 5 years ago in 2009, the first album she released since breaking away from the Hannah Montana character. It was the first different perception we had gotten from Miley Cyrus since that character debuted back in 2003-2004 and went to number one with the single This Is the Life, which debuted in the first season of Hannah Montana. Since being Hannah Montana, Miley has done a lot. In 2014, she's got this album Bangers that has singles like 23, Wrecking Ball, We Can't Stop. They've all found their way to the top of the Billboard chart. What amazes me is we have so many Miley Cyrus critics out there. And just to give you a heads up, this week on our show, we're talking about the Twitter feud between Miley Cyrus and Katy Perry. And if you want to get in on the conversation, we are on Facebook at HEW Entertainment, on Twitter at JonathanClark1, on YouTube at JonathanClark22, and on Google Plus, if you have it, at HEW Entertainment. If you've seen any of these tweets that happened some time ago between Katy Perry and Miley Cyrus, they've been pretty interesting and pretty to the point. Miley does not shy away from telling Katy Perry how she truly feels, nor does Katy Perry in this little heated feud that developed some time ago on Twitter. And it made social media news, and it made talk show news. Every talk show was talking about it, from The Talk to The View. Everybody was giving this the benefit of the doubt, as almost as if it was the biggest thing that happened in entertainment. But since Miley put out that album, I Can't Be Tamed, the album Bangers, which was released in 2013 and still getting great reviews in 2014, we've heard Wrecking Ball, We Can't Stop, everything from Miley Cyrus, and it's been amazing. And I think that we should be giving her the benefit of the doubt more than what we have. It's been an amazing month of July for our fans in Canada. We have broken record temperatures for the first time since 1983. Ever since Canada Day, it's almost like someone flicked a switch and boom, it's been summer ever since. And it doesn't seem to be going to be letting up throughout the month of August. In the first few weeks of August, we've got great temperatures to look forward to. And I think it's going to be just as amazing August as it was July. But the humidity has been absolutely unheard of, absolutely ridiculous. Anywhere from 25 up to almost 40 degrees every single day. And that's something to be proud about. We finally have something to gloat about here in Canada after breaking record temperatures for the first time since 1983 when it comes to the Humidex. It's been amazing. And I'm looking forward to an awesome August. Thank you so much, July. We will miss you. Thank you for your contributions. Ever since Canada Day, it's been summer. And we've been enjoying record temperatures. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark. After the warmest July ever, we're turning it over into August. And this week on our show, I want to talk about the feud on Twitter between Katy Perry and Miley Cyrus. There you see the graphic on our YouTube channel. Miley Cyrus and Katy Perry standing together at an award show, I would assume is where that photo was taken. And they look so happier in happier days of their careers when it seemed like they were, you know, on top. They had nothing against one another. And ever since Miley Cyrus started conveying herself in a different perception from the Hannah Montana character and I Can't Be Tamed, which dropped in 2009, Katy Perry's been taking exception to some of the things that Miley Cyrus has been doing, including lighting up joints on stage, putting fans' underwear in her mouth. She's been very vocal, very opinionated on it. And whose side are you taking in this Twitter feud? That is a question that I want to ask the over 1,000 fans who are listening to our show on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment. Who are you taking the side of in this feud? Are you going with Miley Cyrus? Are you going with Katy Perry? I would love to say that I'm going for Miley Cyrus in this, but I'm not. I'm not going for either one of them. I'm not going to take anyone's side in this feud because it's very inappropriate, in my opinion, to be shooting on one another on Twitter the way these two have, with how successful they have been, especially over the last, I'll say it, last 3 years. It's been amazing. Miley Cyrus has got this album, Bangers, and Katy Perry has been winning awards and producing some of the most phenomenal music videos, and along with that, some of the most phenomenal performances. When you can give such an amazing performance of Dark Horse at so many different award shows, do you really need to be devoting your time to shooting on Miley Cyrus, someone who is really making a name for herself in the entertainment industry? Now, it may seem like I'm taking Miley Cyrus' side in all of this, but I mean, Miley Cyrus doesn't tweet anything worth talking about. I mean, she tweeted about her dog passing away, one of two that she's had for a long time, a couple of days ago. Why do we need to be recognizing that so much? Is it just because Miley Cyrus tweeted it? And apart from that, with things going on in her personal life, she doesn't really tweet much. She tweets usually one-word tweets, like love and peace, if you've seen any of these
on her Twitter. She doesn't really tweet all that much. Love and peace. I mean, really, do we need to be putting that on entertainment news websites? And a while ago, when she first debuted this new hairdo that she has, which was criticized beyond belief, she said it was her hair, her body, and if she wanted to get rid of it, it was going to go bye-bye, and she didn't care how her fans judged her, how her fans perceived her, how her fans choose to accept her. It was her decision to get rid of her long hair, even though a lot of people love that, and they couldn't really do anything about it. So really, Miley doesn't tweet anything that is really worth talking about. She may have tweeted something towards Katy Perry, but I don't think it should be something that, you know, every daytime talk show